It's taken more than 6 years, a diplomatic fallout between nations, and a threat of war. Finally, more than 60 containers of toxic waste are now heading from here in the Philippines back to where they came from, Canada. More than 100 containers, or about 2,500 tons of waste, were shipped here from Canada in 2013 and 14. The Bureau of Customs exposed it then and said the containers had been mislabeled as recyclable rubbish.
I will advise Canada that your garbage is on the way. Prepare a grand reception. Eat it if you want to.
For years, the Philippine government has appealed for Canada to take the trash back. But Canada said its own laws prevent that. Then, the Philippine government set a May 15 deadline for the waste to be sent back. But nothing happened. In response, Duterte recalled its Philippine ambassador and other diplomatic officials from Ottawa. Greenpeace says impoverished communities like this one in downtown Manila are the ones who suffer the most from the disposal of hazardous waste.
Waste, wherever it goes, waste trade is unacceptable because it impinges on the human rights of people who are at the receiving end of the waste. So it violates their right to a healthy life, right to health, right to livelihoods, right to a proper living.
Activists say the Philippines is just one of the many countries in Southeast Asia that have become dumping grounds of toxic wastes from developed countries. This is why there is growing pressure on the Philippine government to impose a total ban on the importation of wastes.
The Malaysian government also says it will send back some 3,000 metric tons of non-recyclable plastic waste to countries like Canada, Australia, and the U.S.
It is grossly unfair for rich countries to send their waste to poor countries simply because the poor countries have no choice. Maybe it contributes a little to their economy.
Activists say what's happening with Canada's waste here is an example of what can be achieved in cleaning up the global recycling industry. Jamela Alindogan, Al Jazeera, Manila.